Hello and welcome to the episode 190 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we have the arrival of a new drummer, a guest appearance, and a band reunion. On the 9th of July 1960, the Silver Beatles performed at the Grosvenor Ballroom in Wallasey, England, for the sixth time. It was a dodgy venue in a bad neighborhood, and the crowd had started being more and more violent before, during, and after the show. Anyway, this was probably the date in which the band tried out their new drummer, Norman Chapman. Chapman was a talented hobbyist that practiced in an office just opposite to the Jacaranda Coffee Bar in Liverpool. One afternoon, manager Alan Williams and the lads heard him playing and were impressed enough to ask him to join. The band then featured Norman Chapman on drums, George Harrison, John Lennon and Paul McCartney on guitar and voice, and Stu Sutcliffe on bass. Moving on to 1962, the Beatles, now featuring Pete Best on drums and Paul McCartney on bass, played the Plaza Ballroom in St. Helens for the third Monday in a row. Another residency in 1963. The Beatles, now with Ringo Starr on drums, performed the second of six consecutive performances at the Winter Gardens in Margate. And now, before taking a huge leap forward, yes, www.simonmas.com/support. Boy, if you three or four listeners had put a link to the show on your social media every time I've asked you to, now the show would be a huge success, with at least 5 listeners per day. That's a 25% increase right there. Just kidding. But you know, do show me your support with a share or a comment. It helps much more than you think, and it builds a community of people interested in music. Thank you. Now, as they say, let's go on with the show. In 1968, Ringo Starr arrived early at the EMI Studios for the Beatles' session and found Solon King busy in Studio 2 with a ballad called 100 Years or More. He ended up contributing hand claps to the song, which was released as B-side of King's single Goodbye, My Old Girl. Soon later, starting at 4 p.m., the Beatles reconvened in Abbey Road for yet another remake of Obladi Oblada, the second. Paul McCartney led the band through the recording of 2 more rhythm track takes, 20 and 21 respectively. During a 1-hour break at 9 p.m, Paul changed his mind again and decided that, in fact, take 13 of the previous remake was the best basis to complete the song. Lead and backing vocals were erased and re-recorded, not for the last time. A reduction mix onto take 22, following further overdubs of hand claps and more vocals, ended the focus on this song. Then the band turned to Revolution, a reworked version of Revolution 1. McCartney and Harrison didn't agree with Lennon on the merits of Revolution 1 as a potential single because it was, quote-unquote, too slow. John, more interested in the political statement than anything else, decided to rearrange the song to make it faster and to give it a harder edge. The lyrics remained almost the same, this time omitting the "and in" from the line "You can count me out." The session ended at 3:30 a.m. with the recording of several rehearsal takes of the new version of the song. 9th of July 1969. It was the first time the four Beatles managed to get together in a studio since the official start of the recording sessions for their next album. At 2:30 p.m, John Lennon returned after his car crash, detailed in episode 182 of this podcast, and arranged for a double-sided bed to be delivered in the studio for Yoko, much to the stupefied annoyance of the studio personnel. Ono was still unwell, and John, knowing that she was pregnant, didn't want to leave her home alone. She was brought in by an ambulance and laid on the bed. After that, on John's request, the studio technicians arranged the microphone hanging over her head in case she wanted to give some insight on the session. Then everything carried on normally. Until 8 p.m., the band recorded 21 takes of the rhythm track for Maxwell's Silver Hammer, with Paul at the piano and George on bass. The song had been tried out during the Get Back sessions, and despite the rest of the band's less than enthusiastic attitude, McCartney was convinced of its potential as a single. After the rhythm track had been taped, the Beatles continued working until 10:15 p.m., overdubbing acoustic guitars on the last two choruses of take 21. And with this, I declare the episode completed. Tomorrow, if you fancy listening, you'll be treated with a Beatles homecoming. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.